Hello guys and Vande Mataram. How are you all? I am Mohit Shneesh and today here we are going to be learning about all those flotation concepts. What are those? Buoyancy, density, Archimedes principle. Yes, today we are going to be learning all these three concepts in one video. It's very good opportunity to you learn here very fast and with very good points. Okay, we have studied them and we have bought only the points which are very important and else things could be told by me with my mouth. So let's begin with the video. And in the beginning, I want to tell you about the buoyancy. Now, when you jump into water, why do you float? Okay, or you are partially immersed. Okay, so what happens is there is a downward force. Try to understand me, there is a downward force. It's attracting us towards Earth. But remember that there is also an upward force which is just taking us up. It is just upwards. Okay, I've already told you that about the thrust. In the previous video, we had studied about thrust and pressure. Now, what is thrust? Thrust is a force that is downwards and also perpendicular. So, it's perpendicular, that is 90 degree. Okay, so now I can also say that the up thrust can be upwards and perpendicular. It doesn't depend that it's like this. However, it can be perpendicular if it forms 90 degree, that is a perpendicular angle, or I can say it's perpendicular line when two lines meet and form 90 degree angle. Okay, so now I know that it's a up thrust. Buoyancy is known as a up thrust. Why it is known as up thrust? Because there is a upward force and that is a thrust or a force that is coming from downside of the water. Okay, now we have understood what is buoyancy completely and we know what is buoyancy and everything. But we don't have any particular SI unit for buoyancy as it is a force or up thrust. We use Newton for this. So now what is density? So now this buoyancy will take us to the concept of density. How? Now when you throw any wood or when you yourself jump into water to swim and have fun, what happens? You float. Yes, or you are partially immersed. What happens? You just observe that you weight. Okay, your weight and also about your pressure what you are putting on water. Or you can also see what is your density. Now buoyancy depends on density. Friends, always remember that density depends on buoyancy. Now water does its job as it puts a force from or gives its force from downside towards the object. But if the density of the object is more, the object will sink because buoyancy depends on density. Buoyancy will not decrease or increase. If the weight of the object is increasing, buoyancy will increase. Now that also takes us to the concept of Archimedes principle and we'll learn that. But now we have come to the point of density. What is density? Density is a density of a substance. It's defined as the mass per unit volume. Mass per unit volume. Now, think a cube. Think of a cube. So this is a cube. It has its length, its breadth, and its height. Am I right? Yes. I am right that it has three sides and volume is calculated in meter cube. It's SI unit is meter cube. Okay, so we all know that when a cube or a wood cube, okay, when wood is thrown, a wood has its length, yes, it has, think that this is a wooden box of wood, okay, so it has its length, it has its breadth and height, okay, so when I throw it, it is partially immersed, or think that this is a stone, then it will sink. Think in two cases, okay. So case 1 and case 2. Now in the case 1 it is partially immersed. So we will only calculate this or the area which is immersed. Now think of the case where it is stored and it is completely, it is now synced. Okay, so it will cover a volume. Okay, now when you go to your farm, I think that this is your farm, then you can cover like the area here. Okay, so this is the area. Sorry, this is the area like this. Okay, this triangle is calculated by area because it has only length and its breadth. Okay, but now we have volume here, volume. Okay, it is 3D shape. This is 2D. Okay, so we are counting volume here. When we throw any stone inside, so we have to get its volume because water also has volume, and we have to see that what water, how much water is displaced by the stone. Here is the point. I was explaining the same thing. So how much water is displaced? Okay, or now density, when you come to point of density, what happens? How compact is the mass? So I know that now when you take any wood and a stone of the same size, they're looking the same, but their weight is also same, but the wood will sink. Wood will sink because density, as compact is the mass, the density will be more. I've told you in the video of density, you can just leave that. Now the question arises, is the mass per unit volume. So how to calculate that? For that we will be learning it in the next minutes. Now this connects us to the concept of Archimedes principle. Yes, Mr. Archimedes gave this principle, and at that time the Eureka word was very famous, and I remember that till now. So Archimedes principle. What is Archimedes principle? First let me make you understand about this. So Archimedes states us that when a body is immersed fully or partially in a fluid, I can also say air, that is also a fluid, and water is also a fluid. Now when you think of thermodynamics, aerodynamics, how aeroplanes fly, we learn it in the next grades. So when a body is immersed fully or partially in a fluid, it experiences an upward force. Okay, that is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by it. Now, okay, for example, I'll draw a tank here of water. Okay, so think that this is a tank. So we have, this is the water level of the tank. So now when a box, like think that I had a cube there, I bought that cube and I am just dipping it here. Okay, so this much of the cube is now immersed. Okay, so this, remember friends, this much of that cube will be displaced by the object. This much water. Okay, so that is displaced. Okay, so when 500 people are sitting in the room, and when 2 come, then what happens? 2 will be removed out, and those two people will be sitting there, or they take the seats. Okay, so they displaced 2 people. Okay, so what Archimedes is trying to tell us, when a body is immersed fully or partially, now it is partial thing, okay, in a fluid, it experiences an upward force, buoyant force, or I can say a thrust, it experiences. Okay, so it experiences an upward force that is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by it. So this buoyancy or a buoyant force, how much it is, to measure that, that depends on the weight it has displaced. So we have now is Archimedes principle. So Archimedes principle. So this is what called Archimedes principle. So we all know this, and if you like our content really, then please like us and support us and subscribe my channel, then you get all those notification and click that all button on the notification bell, and if you will get the notifications easily when we upload the video on YouTube. And comment below how our videos are, and also about the concepts which you want. Like if you tell me to teach you calculus also, I'm ready to do anything for you people, because sharing knowledge can increase our knowledge. So thank you by saying the great thought. Thank you. Jai Hind.